Our Fortify DAST tools offer comprehensive API testing. I'd like to first talk about our strategy when approaching API testing. First, we look at the attack surface, making sure we understand all of the endpoints and parameters that need to be tested, being able to onboard those through schemas, but also API discovery. Second is authentication. We need to make sure we are authenticated and maintain a session with that API to get good scans. Third is the attack vectors. These are the attacks we're sending, not only traditional denial of service and injection attacks, but those specific to APIs, many of them being authentication attacks. And fourth, we have to be able to scale, so we need to automate this. Let's first take a look at attack surface. With Fortify DAST, we can use our API discovery feature to find APIs and endpoints customers may not even be aware of. Here's an example of us discovering a GraphQL endpoint. From this endpoint, we interact with GraphQL's introspection and pull the entire API into the current scan. There's no need to run a separate API scan if we discover an API mid-scan. It can be consolidated into a single scan. We can also run that API scan separately if we want a more targeted scan. We can also use schemas to define the attack surface of an API. In this case, we'll use a Postman collection, but we have several other options. This includes Swagger and Open API definitions, OData, GraphQL, gRPC, SOAP, WSDLs, and our more legacy SOAP design files. For Postman, we have two collections for this API. One is a workflow. This is a traditional Postman collection. And we also need an environment file, which will define some specific variables within that collection. Here we could set some additional network authentication if we need. However, this API requires a bearer token. After validating the Postman collection, we'll be able to take a look at all of the endpoints and define that authentication. In this case, we're going to use a static token. So this will define a custom header with a pre-configured bearer token. Now, if we needed more dynamic authentication, we can do that as well. This is where we can query a specific endpoint with parameters and pull back a token that can be refreshed during the scan. This works very well for short-lived tokens. In addition, for some of our API types, such as GraphQL and Swagger, we can actually use our macros and run a macro that runs and triggers generation of a new token and pull that into the scan to keep that authentication consistent in that session in play. So we know our endpoints are defined and good. Next, we look at our attack vectors. So we default to our API policy, but we have many different defined policies that we could use. In this case, I'm going to keep the API policy. It has all the traditional injection style attacks, environmental attacks, but it also has all of our authentication attacks, such as OAuth, OAuth2, JWT style tokens, bearer token attacks, to make sure APIs are secure. And we'll start our scan. Now in Web Inspect, it's a great tool for that single scan. All of these features are also available in Scan Central DAST, which is our platform for automation. It's a great way to queue up additional scans, run them on a schedule, or run them in a dev pipeline. Now this scan does take a few minutes, so I'm going to jump over to another version of it that I've already run. This scan took 4 minutes, 14 seconds, and we can actually look at all of our different endpoints that we hit, see our different attacks, just as we do any WebInspect scan. Now we'll take a look at how to use a schema to set up a API scan in WebInspect. We have several options to choose from: OpenAPI, Swagger, OData, Postman, SOAP, as well as our new support for native GraphQL as well as gRPC. In this case, we're going to use GraphQL. Select Next. Here's where we set up our authentication, which is another key component of successfully scanning an API. We have several options to choose from here as well: traditional network auth, custom authentication using complex interactions with the API. In this case, we'll use a bearer token. This is a long-lived token, but if it was a shorter one or one that we needed to reestablish at some point during the scan, we could use an endpoint within the API, have it defined here where we'd call it to get it updated, or we could even use a macro where that interaction with the API is pre-recorded, and anytime we lost state, it'd be rerun to reestablish that token. We can also establish things like client-side certificates and any sort of custom header we may need. Here's where we can set up some of our business logic, including and excluding API endpoints, as well as setting specific parameter values that may be needed for the API to run successfully. We'll go ahead and parse the definition, make sure everything looks good. Then we also have where we need to set our attack vectors. This is through our policy. By default, we typically use our API policy. This is a good mix of both injection attacks, environmental attacks, as well as API-specific attacks, including a number of them around authentication, things like OAuth2, JWT tokens, to make sure those are secure. We'll keep this with our API policy for now. We can set any additional settings we need. Begin the scan. This scan is running, but it does take a few minutes to run, so I'm going to jump over to one I previously ran. This scan took just under 13 minutes. We can start seeing our findings, as well as see how we interacted with the site, the various endpoints we interacted with, the parameters that were sent, and start reviewing our findings.